Today, we're still on our hot solar station series, and the one we're covering today is our, what's called our Drainpack Solar Hot Water Station. And you see it behind me. So this is a, they come in 80, standard 80 or 120 gallon tanks, and they're a complete package. It's like buying a, you know, a TV. You just kind of plug it in, and you have to run your modem and things to it. But it's complete. It's completely built here at SunEarth. We pressure test it, electrically test it, and it's all ready to go. The advantage to these stations is you don't, the installer, it saves them time. It saves them a lot of time. He doesn't have to worry about any installation snafus that he has, because this is all pressure tested, like I mentioned. It's all ready to go. The major components of this solar station, it's called the drain pack again, and what a drain, it's a drain down system. And the advantage of this, besides it's all pre-built with drain back, with the drain pack, this is the drain pack, so that's where we get the name. Drain back is the design. Is that in the summer, if everything gets hot or you go away on vacation, you can just turn this off and all the fluid from the roof drains into this drain pack, and then you're fine. The system can sit up there. There's nothing going on the roof. In the winter, same thing. At the end of the day, the system shuts off and all the fluid drains out. So again, there's nothing as far as freeze goes, which is the two things that this protects against, is freeze and then overheating issues that happen in the desert. Or again, if you go away on vacation, if you have a, say, have a vacation home, this would be good. You just unplug it and be done. The tank, the drain pack system consists of the storage tank, which holds 80 or 120 gallons of water. It has the drain pack, which is the reservoir for the drain, for the drain system, drain back. It has an expand. This is a potable expansion tank. It's like a shock absorber. The expansion tank is this little unit here. It has a bladder inside that, when the water in the tank, 80 or 120, heats up, this bladder moves and takes up the expansion. It's like blowing a bag, plastic bag, up a little bit more, and it expands to take up the added pressure. So that's on all our systems. Very important to keep your tank at a relatively constant pressure. As the drain pack is this is the main thing, obviously, you see, and that's plumbed to the ports on the tank. So the tank has a heat exchanger, so that heat exchanger transfers the heat from the roof to the tank, to the water you're going to use out of your fixtures. The system, it has a sight glass, so you can see the level in your tank, in your drain pack tank, so you know that it's working. It's filled, it's about here, and then when it's running, it's about two-thirds the way down, because of pumping water or fluid out of the drain pack into the panels of that. The way that all happens is there's a pump. This is a Grundfos stainless steel pump that's placed toward, it's toward the bottom, so it's down here connected to the tank, and then it's wired into the pump. So this pump circulates the fluid through the panels and back, and the pump turns on with the next component of the system, which is the control. That's our solar control. It monitors the temperature on the roof and the bottom of the tank, and when the roof is warmer, then it activates this pump, this little Grundfos pump here, and circulates the fluid until the temperature on the roof is close to or equal to the tank temperature, then it turns off. At night it turns off. If it's real cloudy, it won't be running because the temperature on the roof is cold. So this little brain of the system, this our solar controller, It has three sensors to tell you the temperatures. One is on the roof, one is at the bottom of the tank, and one's at the top of the tank to let you know that the temperature on the top is warm enough to use. The other portion we have a safety valve on this, on the drain pack, that if for whatever reason there was a overpressure situation, it would open and it would drain the fluid down to a safe location. Now there's only a fixed amount of fluid here, so it wouldn't go for, this is not like a typical safety valve that might open and stay running. This would only release a certain amount and stop. So we have a safety valve. We have there's a balancing valve that is on the system that allows you to balance the flow for adjustments. That's usually done by the installer. Again, everything on this is complete for the solar part of it. And what the installer does is connect here, and these lines here go up to the roof. So that's the installer's job. He installs this, and the filling process is pretty straightforward. You just fill this up. There's a valve down here at the bottom of the tank, and you just fill it up with fluid until the fluid's about here. You know, slowly, and then turn the fluid off. Then you run it. You know, we do the test, the commissioning, we call it, and then you turn it off, and the fluid should come back to where we filled it, and then you know it's ready to go. It's all pre-tested for leaks, and it's ready to go. You don't have to do anything. Just set the tank where you want. In certain areas, you need earthquake straps for seismic, Hawaii, California, and others now. And so the tank's ready to go. On the potable side, which potable means drinkable water that comes out of your fixtures, but the main component, and it's all plumbed in, is what's called the tank booster or mixing valve assembly. This allows the hot water out of the tank, not this, out of the big tank, the 80 or 120, to be mixed with cold water so you don't scald yourself. It's usually set at about 120, 125. It's so your solar tank, you can generate up to about 140 or 150 in the tank if the sun's out, and then mix it down so you don't scald yourself. There's a little thermometer on here to let you know. You can check. It actually tells you when you open a faucet, it tells you what the temperature of the water is coming out. All this is all pre-plumbed on the tank, ready to go. There's manuals that come with the system, so you have the manuals for each individual component in the system. You have manual for the tank booster, and you have a pump manual, a control manual. It even comes with an expansion tank manual and its own manual, its own solar drain pack hot water station manual. So you get quite a bit of paperwork. There's also more information on our website, and that'll be discussed in the future. Just go online and find it. The parts on top, you see some flexible lines. These are water lines that connect the potable water, and then you have a couple of valves up here as part of this assembly, and that allows you to bypass the tank in case you have to service it. So it's bypassing the big 80 or 120 gallon tank. So if this is connected in line with like a tankless, or a heat pump, or a gas standard water heater, or an electric water heater, it's in line. You can bypass this, so it's like going around like a truck bypass on a freeway. You go around it and go right to your primary or existing water heater, and then you can service the tank and then bring it back online. The other item that comes with these tanks is if this is your only water heater in the house, what it has, and let's say it's been cloudy for a couple days and there's no more solar energy, it has an element which goes in this little access cover. This goes into the tank. It's immersed. It's like an immersion heater. And then it's sealed in, and then it has a thermostat. And these two items are hooked up to 240 volts of power. And then the thermostat you can set to, it's a 110 to 170, we recommend no higher than 140. So you can also obtain heat in the tank by energizing this element and thermostat in the tank to bring the tank up to temperature. Some people have time clocks or they have big switches on it, they can do it manually, or they have a timer that brings it on in the morning early. And then, so it's on for an hour, and then it turns the power off, so your tank, you have enough to shower if it's been cloudy. And then it lets it, it keeps the element off all midday, and then it comes on maybe at 3 or 4 o'clock. So if it's just, we're having cloudy weather, then the element comes back on and reheats the tank, so you have hot water in the evening. And then it usually, some people leave it on all night, some people turn it off after 10, and then have it come on at 4 or something. So that's the secondary heat source that you have if this is your only heater. And some people have it, it's what they have. It's just like with our other systems, they have our other hot water stations we've discussed, they have an auxiliary element to allow you to heat the water in inclement weather. Primary benefit of the hot water stations, they're completely tested here and built here. They're ready to go electrically and liquid, no tests, I mean no leaks. They also, with this particular drain pack hot water station, it protects against freezes on the solar collectors, and it protects for overheating of the solar collector fluid, especially in the summer or periods where you're on vacation. You can just turn the control. Control has a little switch here. You can turn it off. There's a kind of like on, you may have on your furnace, you have a manual on and off and auto. It's in auto generally. Turn it off and it all drains down. Your fluid level is, when it's running would be here, you turn it off and the fluid level comes back up. You're just ready to go. You go on your cruise, your trip, you know, go visit the kids or whatever you want, but it's completely, it's kind of dormant. It's just waiting for you to come back. Now that's just for the solar loop. The tank still has water in it, so that's something, if you wanted to turn all the water off to the house, you could do that, and then you don't have to worry about a leak in your water system of the house. And then you just, basically when you do that, turn off the element to the tank, and that's again with all our solar stations, turn the element off and go away if the element is part of the system. Any questions, you can always email us. You can go online and send us a question on our website, www.sunearthinc.com. That's sunearthinc, all one lowercase, inc.com. Thank you.